Yeah, in addition to the tens of thousands of federal workers who wouldn't be showing up to work on Monday if the government does go into shutdown mode, a lengthy standoff could have a serious ripple effect in a number of areas, not the least of which the housing market.
In an industry so closely tied to the overall economy, Manchester mortgage broker Dennis Kochanek says the last thing the housing market needs is a government shutdown.
What you're going to see is you're going to see processes and procedures get delayed, which could have an impact on the overall mindset of the buyer out there in the public.
With more than half of the loan applications in his office run through government programs like the FHA and the VA, Kochanek says one big problem is the system that provides tax return verifications will be shut down, making approvals very difficult.
They're still funding those loans up front, but that could be delayed on the back end, which could cause some delays for lenders.
And what about those tax returns? Well, if Uncle Sam does take a break, he still wants you to file and pay up by April 18th if you owe. But if you're due a refund, that may take a while.
Taxpayers should continue to file the returns by April 18th. They should e-file if they can. Otherwise, again, probably expect somewhat of a delay for paper returns that are paper filed.
At least the self-funded post office will stay open to not deliver those refund checks. And if you're worried about Social Security, Medicaid, or welfare checks, the Treasury Department says they will continue. But if you're planning a trip to a national park or an attraction, you might want to call ahead.
Also, if you're one of the thousands of New Hampshire residents to count on those long-term unemployment benefits backed by the federal government, some good news. Don't worry. The Treasury reports those checks are going to continue. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.